You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we talk about high performance serving with Triton Inference Server in AzureML with Shivani. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show, where we're talking about high performance serving with Triton Inference Server in AzureML. We've got a special guest. Shivani, how you doing, my friend?
I'm doing good. How about you?
Fantastic. Why don't you tell us who you are and what you do?
Sure. So, hi, everyone. My name is Shivani. I am PM on the Azure Machine Learning team. I work on model deployment and serving, and currently I'm focusing on how to best integrate open source softwares with our product.
Fantastic. So let's talk about serving or inference. Why don't you describe what it is and then tell us about the challenges that are around doing that.
Yeah, but definitely. So model deployment and serving is when you have completed, you have trained your model, you have a final model that you want to deploy as web service, send requests to it, and get some output from the web service. So one of the problems that customers are facing into that they have to worry about maintaining different frameworks. They have to worry about, and they are looking into high-performance inferencing solution. And they want this one inferencing server that could cater to all their needs, all their use cases, and of course, just bring model to AzureML and deploy them seamlessly.
I mean, it sounds easy, but our research shows that it's hard, very hard. Like building a model is so easy, but then getting it to actually provide business value is super hard. How is Azure helping folks do that?
Definitely. So as you know, we have this feature called managed online endpoints where customers don't have to maintain their infrastructure and they get capabilities like safe rollout, security, monitoring, and a lot more. And we are integrating our managed online endpoint with NVIDIA's Triton Inferencing Server. So Triton Inferencing Server is an open source software which supports multiple frameworks like TensorFlow, TensorRT, PyTorch, Onyx, a lot more. It is a high performance server, inferencing server. So Triton runs model concurrently on GPUs to maximize your throughput and utilization. Hence, it gives our customers best of both worlds. And you only have to focus on your machine learning model and deployment.
And that's basically what we want to do. We just once we build the model, we just want to put it out. It sounds harder than it should be. Can you show us how this works?
Definitely. So can you see my coding screen?
We sure can.
Okay, so in Azure Machine Learning, when you're deploying your managed online endpoint, you need to have two YAMLs, your endpoint YAML and your deployment YAML. So I have my endpoint YAML here. Name of my endpoint is Triton Multimodels Endpoint, auth mode I'm putting as AML token, and then I'll hit AzureML online endpoint create command to create my endpoint. Now, one endpoint can have multiple deployments. I'm adding one deployment to this endpoint called Blue. And to this endpoint, to this deployment, actually, I'm passing my model. And if you can see, I'm saying here sample multi-models. So I'm actually passing multiple models to one endpoint. So one of my model that here I have is BIDAF model. So it's question and answering model. You give them some context, you ask a question, it answers you. And another is DenseNet Onyx model, which is a simple image classification model. So I'm passing these two different models to one endpoint. An important parameter to note here is model format as Triton. Once you put as model format as Triton, we understand it's a no-code deployment. So by no-code deployment, we mean is you don't need a scoring script, you don't need an environment. Triton expects your model to be in particular model repository format, which we'll talk in a few seconds, and that's it. You give your model endpoint deployment name, the SKU, and you hit AzureML online deployment create command.
All right, so just a couple of questions as you're doing that. The first question I have is, so this is basically a multi-model deployment that's doing question answering and image recognition, some sort of image recognition. That's the first question. Am I getting that right?
Yep. So we have two different models here. One is BIDAF9 and another is DenseNet Onyx model.
Fantastic. The second question I have, and this is something that I'm used to doing, don't I usually have to write like a scoring file with these models? You mentioned that it's no code. How is that possible?
Yep, so usually when you deploy, there is a file called init and run function, which one loads your model and another takes inputs and outputs to score your model. But with Triton, when we are integrating, we auto-generate that for you. So you do not need your scoring script, you do not need your environment. And actually in a bit, we'll go to the logs and see that our server has started, our model has loaded. So really it becomes easy to just bring in your models to Azure Machine Learning.
Another question I have is, how long does it take to deploy these things? Are we talking like hours, days?
Oh, no, definitely not. It takes, for this deployment, it took me under 10 minutes, 7 to 8 minutes to complete the deployment. Hence, I have like an endpoint running so that we can go to that and see how it looks.
Awesome. So two final questions, the two YAML files. So the managed endpoint YAML file basically describes like an HTTP style endpoint, and then you're adding deployments to that endpoint with the other one. Am I getting this right?
Perfect. Yep.
See, look at that. I knew a thing or two about that. All right. Can you show us what the outcome of this is?
Yeah, definitely. So once I hit my endpoint create and deployment create command, I'm coming to this Azure Machine Learning Studio where you can visualize everything very nicely. So I have my endpoint, I have my blue deployment, the multiple models that I deployed to this. You can see your environment is AzureML Triton Server Ubuntu Inference NCD environment. It's a mouthful, but basically we generated this environment for you. We use this no-code deployment underneath, so you don't have to do it. We load the Triton Inferencing server for you.
I see. Can we scroll down? Because I want to make sure I understand. So basically what's happening is there is a pre-built environment. I'm assuming it's an image or a container of some kind.
Yep.
That just basically knows about the way Triton things are deployed. Am I getting this right?
Yep, exactly. So we can actually go and look into this environment, and hopefully my internet is working nicely and it's still loading.
Cool. Here we go.
Yep, you see it directly pulls your image from Triton server.
So it's not like we're inventing a new thing. This is something yes. NVIDIA already does. We're literally just pulling down their thing.
Yep. Yes. So you don't. So as a new user, you don't really have to know that you need to use environment for deployment. We do that for you. We just pull that NVCR image for you, so it's ready for your inferencing.
Awesome. And so, how would someone, if they want to now call this endpoint, how would they do that?
Definitely. So now we have, just before we go that, you see in my deployment logs, mm-hmm. I can actually see that my model and my server is ready. Once this is, I can go and score against my different models. So just to keep in mind before we go to the endpoint is, this is my model one name and this is my another model name. And then you want to score, or let's just say when we'd want to do a GET request to this model, Triton multimodel inferencing.com, this you can get from our studio. So it's right here, your REST endpoint. And next you put is V2 models, your model name and versions and one. So this everything remains same, just this will change whatever your model name is, you would replace that. And when I do a GET request, I see what input the model expects for me to score.
And that's all basically the Triton format of doing things with models.
Yeah, exactly. So cool. There is one caveat with Triton is it does expect your model to be in specific model repository format. And they have very beautifully defined in their GitHub repo of different model repository format expected by different frameworks models. So TensorRT, Onyx, right now we have Onyx models. So we follow this, TorchScript, TensorFlow, all the frameworks that they support.
Okay, cool. All right, and so basically once you've decided as an organization to use the Triton way of doing things, then it's literally just saying, here's my endpoint, here's the deployment that I'm gonna do, and that's it. I mean, it feels like it's a little too easy.
that's the goal, that you can do your high performance inferencing on GPUs, load multiple models or single model depending on your use case, and just make it easy for you to deployment.
I mean, that's cool. Is there anything that I'm missing? Anything else you want to show us?
No, that would be all. just to see that how easy it is for you to deploy this model. So we can actually look at our model's UI screen. And you see this is the model that I deployed, samples, multimodal, that's my model name. Format, you can see Triton, it recognizes. If you remember in our YAML, we did put model format as Triton. And when I come to the artifacts, this is the model format that is expected by Triton. My model name, version, model.onyx, model name, version, model.onyx. That's it. I just have to have my model repository in the expected format.
And again, this is really cool. Like we've been talking about, it's really hard to get models into business value quickly. This feels like it's one of the ways to do it, a powerful way. Where can people go to find out more?
Definitely. So we have links here for our docs, documentation, and samples. So you can go and try out and see how easy it is for you to deploy.
All right. So there's a link for the docs. Here's the link for the, there's a blog as well that they told us about. Make sure you go check that out. And the samples are all here. This has been amazing. Thank you so much for being with us, Shivani.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much for having me.
And thank you so much for watching. We're learning all about high performance serving with Triton Inference Server in AzureML. Thanks for watching, and hopefully we'll see you next time. Take care.